Welcome to Living Waters Church. We're so glad you're worshiping with us today. We'd like to welcome all of our first or second time guests. We'd like for you to fill out a connect card. You can find that in the pew back in front of you. Fill that out, bring it to our connect desk in the main foyer, and we will be happy to greet you and welcome you and find out more about you when you turn that card in. God bless you. Thanks again for choosing to worship with us. We want to invite you to join us this Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. for our Midweek Connect. We have adult Bible study, we have shift students for teens and middle schoolers, we have Awana clubs for kids, and a Spanish worship service. Our adult Bible study will include food and fellowship, so make sure you come and be a part of that with us this Wednesday for Midweek Connect. We also offer Bible study on Thursdays at 10 a.m. in the Fellowship Hall with Lewis Warren. Everyone is invited to attend that Bible study. Mark your calendars for Easter weekend at Living Waters. We are so excited for Easter, and on Good Friday, we'll gather at 6:30 p.m. for a time of worship and communion. Then on Easter Sunday, we'll have three worship services. We'll have an 8:30 and a 10:30 service for our English congregation in the main sanctuary, and then we'll have a 10 a.m. service for our Spanish congregation in the South Sanctuary. All services will have Glow Kids provided, so please come and be a part of Easter at Living Waters Church. We're so excited to celebrate the fact that He is risen.
Well, good morning, Living Waters Church. Have you come today ready to praise the Lord? Come on and stand to your feet. Let's just enter into His presence this morning. Lord, we thank You. We praise You. What a good day it is to come into this house and magnify You. Lord, we lay our praise and our worship at Your feet, and we welcome You, Holy Spirit.
Come on, put your hands together. Whoa. That You are good. Oh, come on, if you believe it, say You are good. Oh, in the sunlight. Come on, my life celebrates.
My life celebrates.
You are good.
You are good.
Stop!
Bless you, Lord. Somebody give the Lord a shout of praise if you know he's good. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, we thank you for the blessing that you give to us, Lord. Come on, if you're thankful for his blessings on your life, would you just give him a wave offering in the house this morning? You say, Lord, thank you for your blessings. Thank you for the blessing, Lord. Hallelujah. Lift your hands all over the room. We bless you, Jesus. We bless you, Lord. We want to sing this song this morning as a song of blessing over you, blessing over this church, blessing over God's people. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Oh, hallelujah. Come on, if you agree this morning, let's sing it together. Say amen. Oh,
amen. Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Say, the Lord bless you. Say,
the Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you
and give you peace.
And give you peace.
And together we agree, we say, thank you for your favor. We thank you for your mercy. God, we pray favor upon every family, upon your church. Hallelujah. Come on, sing it.
May his favor be upon you and 1,000 generations and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his presence be upon you and 1,000 generations and your family and their children and your children and their children.
Oh, may his favor be upon you and 1,000 generations and your family and your children and their children and their children. Say, may his favor be upon you and 1,000 generations. family and your children and their children. And their may his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you, he is with you in the morning, in the evening, in your coming and your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He is for you, 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 he is for you.
May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations.
Come on, in your family.
And your family and your children and their children and their children.
May his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you.
He is with you, he is with you. In the morning,
yes, he is.
In the evening,
in the coming,
in the coming,
oh, and you're going,
and you're weeping, and rejoicing.
He is for you,
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 he is for you.
just the voices.
Amen.
Come on, say it.
Amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
We bless you, Lord. 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 Come on, just take a minute and worship him in his presence. Come on, his presence is in the room.
Oh, thank you for your blessing. Oh, we praise your name, God. We magnify your name. We magnify your name. Oh, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus.
Come on, let's lift our hands all over this building. Hey, listen to me. I think this was a setup today. We don't have anybody that's getting baptized in water, but there's another baptism. There's a greater baptism. And if you don't have it today, it may be your day. This may be Baptism Sunday. And so if you're hungry today and you're thirsty today, God said he would fill you up. Say, well, Pastor, how do I get it? You just ask for it. That was my last words as a Baptist. God, if this is real, I want it. It was real. It's still real. And it's to 1,000 generations, to your children, their children. That's the promise. Come on, I just want you to just lift your hands right where you are and just say, Lord, fill me today. Fill me. Fill me with the Holy Ghost today. Baptize me with fire today.
Fill me with your Holy Ghost.
You may have had the Holy Ghost over half your life or most all of your adult life. Ask him to refill you today. Fresh fire, God, fresh fire. New oil today, God, new wine today. Whatever it is, God, we want it today. Come on, just tell him more, Lord. I want more. I just want more.
I want more of you. Oh, I want more of you. More of your power, more of your glory.
Oh, just fill us today, God. God, we didn't come to create something. We didn't come here today to make something happen. But we came here today expecting you, God. Expecting you. I wouldn't have come to this place today, God, if you weren't going to be here.
More of you, God.
I could be anywhere else today, God, but I wanted to come here. I wanted to come here. Because you've never failed to meet me here. I've failed to meet you a lot of places, God.
Set a fire down in my
I don't have time to tell everybody how much I've been a disappointment to you, Father, but I'm asking you today, God,
more of you, God,
to meet us here today.
I want more of you,
just more
God.
Of you.
Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain.
What I can't contain.
I can't control.
I can't control it.
I want more of you,
just more, God.
God,
more of you.
I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control. I want more of you, God. I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain, that I can't control. I want more of you, God.
I want more of you, God. Set a fire down in my soul
that I can't contain, that I can't control.
If you don't mean it, don't say it. If you don't mean it, don't say it. But if you really mean it today,
set a fire down in my soul that I can't contain and I can't control.
I want more.
I want more of you, God. 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 I want more of you, God.
Our young people are with us today from Children's Church, and we're so glad they're here. And this is what they need to see. This is what they need to experience today. They need to know that there's more. There's more. If you've got a grandchild or a child with you today, just lay hands on them right where they are. Just love on them. Come on, tell them how proud you are of them.
Let your glory fall, God. Jesus.
If you're standing next to one of our younger children, just lay your hand over gently on their shoulder and just pray for God's greatness and God's glory to come into their life. I want more.
I want more of you.
And listen, some of you that are not familiar with this, you may be hearing somebody speaking in an unknown tongue next to you, and sometimes they get excited, and sometimes it's a little louder than what maybe it's supposed to be, but you don't know what they went through this week. You don't know what they've had to face. You don't know what kind of problem they've dealt with. And so you just understand today that this person, when they're doing that, they're pouring their heart out to God. And God is filling them and helping them. So don't be afraid of it today. Don't be afraid of it today. And does everybody get it right? No. Are we out of order sometimes? Yes. We're humans, human beings. Our hearts are inherently evil because we live in a broken world and we have to stay in a broken body until we get out of this place. But does God still want to come in? Yes. Does God still want to fill up every crack in your crack pot? Yes. He wants to fill every vacancy that you've got. I just want more, God. I just want more, God. Willie, the best is yet to come, buddy. Come on, just lift your hands today and trust him, would you? The best is yet to come. The best is yet to come. Steve, the best is yet to come, buddy. It's yet to come. Jonathan, he gave him to you. You know that, don't you? He gave him to you. You prayed for him, didn't you? He gave him to you. He just wants to remind you today, he gave him to you. He gave him to you. Come on, this is your personal time. Come on, this is your personal time.
We love you. Yes, we love you. Yes, we glorify your name. We magnify your name. And we love you.
Yes, we do, Lord.
Yes, we love you.
Years ago when I was pastoring my second church that I planted, we were in a borrowed room one night. We'd rented a building. We were in a room, a little small room, and there was a bunch of teenagers there that night. And it felt like this. This is what it felt like. It felt like this. And they just lifted their hands, and they weren't hardly above a whisper. And God was filling them with the Holy Ghost one after another. And they weren't loud and going bananas like I thought they was supposed to. But God showed me that He comes in different ways at different times, different seasons. And so don't ever think He's not doing things in the quiet moments. Sometimes that's when He's doing the greatest things. When you don't understand it, that's when He's usually here. When you think it's supposed to be something different, that's usually when He's here. Come on, just your way, your words. Tell Him you want more today. Just more, God. Just more. Just more. Just more. More. Sing that song. Lean against You and breathe. Feel Your heartbeat. Come on, sing it like you live it, Pam. Pour it into it. Let this be your prayer today. Come on, listen to the song.
The more I find You, the more I love You. I want to sit at Your feet, drink from the cup in Your hand.
Overwhelming today, God. Facebook or YouTube, right there in your living room. Come on, worship with us. Don't just watch, but participate with us today.
The more. more I find you, the more I love you,
the more I seek you,
the more I seek you.
I know when I seek, I will find you,
the more I find you.
Worship you, Lord. I love you. Worship you, Lord. We love you. I don't want to get ahead of him. I don't want to be behind him. Sometimes I want him just to hold me. Come on, for too long we've sought his hand. He said to seek his face. You ever had a child put their hands on your face? That's what he wants today. Just put your hand on his face. Come on, will you do something silly with me today? Look at me. Do something silly with me today, would you? Come on, just as though he were standing in front of us, put your hands on his face. Now just close your eyes and trust Him. Trust Him. Just trust Him. Just trust Him. Put your trust in Him.
Eli, Shundo, Isataya, Rabokotaramasi, Ilamoko, Rabaki, Ishataya, Rabokotaramasaya, Ilamoko, Ilamasi, Shataya, Rabokotarabashandaramasaya. For yea, I hear the cries and the worship of my people.
Yes.
More than hearing, I am in your midst today. This is a generation that is crying out desperately for the move of my spirit. I believe that I am in the midst of a people that would answer the call. But I ask you today, will you come up a little higher, my children? Will you come up a little higher, my children? Will you allow me truly to have my way, to consume all of you, to consume all of you? I ask you this day, would you respond? I desire for you to respond. And I thank you for allowing me to move and work in your midst. As you respond to me, you will see the goodness of your God. You will see my mercy and my hand moving and working. Continue, my people, to respond this day, says the Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Come on, somebody give Him praise. Greg. Greg, come here a minute. Come here just a minute. Get your boy. Come here. Bass, come here. I'll need your help. Come here, John. Come here, I want you boys to come up on the second step with me. We're going to take communion in just a minute. Get up here on the second step with me. John, come over in front of me. Do me a favor. Stay down there where you're at. I want him to do something. Just put your hands on Daddy's face. God's going to do something for him right now. Look at this. I didn't even have to tell him. He laid hands on him. He didn't put his hands on his face. He laid hands on him. Listen. God made covenant between fathers and sons. Sons and fathers. And this is what He wants. This is what He wants, Greg. Just put your hand on God's face like this. This is what He wants. This is what He told me just a few minutes ago. I just want you to feel better now. I'm going to write you a check tomorrow for $1,000 from the church, and I want to take an offering up today for your ministry. I don't want you to worry. I don't want you to worry. I don't want you to... God's got you. I don't want you to worry. Come on, He's been tried by fire right now, folks. He's poured everything He's got into this ministry. And the enemy's drained Him physically and emotionally and financially. God can fix everything, including the financial part. He can use us today. If these boys have ever helped you, if they've ever come to your house, if they've ever cut your grass, if they've ever moved a tree limb, if they've ever poured a driveway for you, whatever they've done for you, they did it out of love. You know what somebody told me the other day? He said, Pastor, I know you got a great ministry. Greg's got a great ministry, but I keep losing tree jobs to him. And I said, what are you talking about? He said, I give him a bid and Greg gives him a bid. And he said, we're a half a mile apart. And he said, they give him the business. And I said, that's not why they give him the business. They give him the business because he seeks God and the kingdom of God and all of His righteousness. Then all these other things are added to him. You don't have to charge somebody what you can. You charge him what God wants you to. And this is what he tries to do. He's blessed you. I know he has. We're going to bless them today. We're going to do a lot of things in just a short time. We're going to take communion. We're going to drink from the cup in his hand. And we're going to let God keep healing Pastor Greg right now. And I call him that with all respect because that's who he's going to be. And Pastor Jonathan, that's who they're called to be. Oh, come on, just let him do this today, people. Don't. Come on, do it again, Lord. Just do it again. Just do it again. Greg, God said 1,000 wasn't enough. We need to give you 2,000. I'm telling you, right in my heart, God said anybody can give $1,000. You too. It's not about the money. It's about the God. This money, listen. I just talked to a man earlier, and I wouldn't embarrass him for the world. And he said, I've given all my money away. I just kept enough for some tools. Hey, come on, I ain't never seen an armored car in a cemetery. Making a final deposit with you. You ain't taking nothing with you. Just give it away. Listen, it'll beat you back. I'm trying to find that stuff I got hid. I got it. I found it. I keep one of them hid in here. Most of you men do too. I'm going to do this the way that I feel like God wants me to do because I can. I want two ushers to come help me real quick. I want you to come. Let's roll this box, Carell, right over here behind these guys. Now, I want you two to surrender your bags to carry into Willie right here in front. I want you to give him your bags. Come on, boys. Come on. Stand over in front of this box. This is ministry. You all going to listen. You know what this means? You already got one job here. You can be an usher when Greg lets you. Look, hey, Greg, look here. Look what I just got somebody put in my hand. Look at that. Bob, we'd say in Kentucky, we ain't seen none of them since Daddy worked in the mines. That's, if you can't see it, that's five $100 bills. Come on, come on. I'm just telling you, you can get, God can fix it in a New York minute if you just trust him today. Come on. Let me have that. I just wanted to pray over. And when the elders come, what would you just stay down here with us, would you? We're going to pray over the offering, and I'm going to have to call an audible. Come on, the blood.
Oh, the blood of Jesus. It washes white.
You say, well, Pastor, this is not Mission Sunday. Listen, my Lord, every Sunday's Mission Sunday.
Healing in the blood of Jesus.
He's never going to start.
Oh, there's healing in the blood. Of Jesus, there's healing in the blood of Jesus. It washes.
The reason I held on this money is the man that put it in my hand. I want God to touch him. I want you to stretch your hand this way. I want you to. I mean, he realizes this is just paper. This paper does things for people that they can't do for themselves, but it's just paper. And God will beat him to the bank, I promise you. God will beat him to the bank. But I want God to bless this man. Would you just hold your hand up as a blessing, Father? In the name of Jesus, you know the man that gave me this. You bless him, God. God, not just financially, you've already blessed him. You bless him spiritually. physically, emotionally. God, you give him great days on this earth. Let his greatest days be yet to come because of his faithfulness and his obedience today. In a name that's above every name, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. And that bag there. Everybody had an opportunity to bring their tithe and offering. Carrie, you and Willie, hand your, just hand your bags to these ushers. Elders. I'm sorry. They've got it. Pastor Correll, go ahead and anoint that old box down there, and you and the elders get ready to pray over it. By what? Listen. Whatever we give away comes back. Not just what we gave away, but God usually multiplies it by 100. So we can't give too much away. He's net. Listen, I heard somebody say this a few minutes ago. Look at these two little babies holding each other down here. Look at this. When God's touching children, folks, when God's touching children, and you don't feel something, you better get down here and knock me down to pray. When God's touching children and you don't feel something in your heart, you've let your wood get wet. You better get down here and let it get dried out. Go ahead and pray over that offering, fellas. Thankful for the blood. Thankful for the blood. For it washes white. Father, thank you. Taurus, bring me a tray of that communion stuff. I want the elders to take communion before we leave. Bring me a tray of it. Would you get your elements for communion? I want the elders are going to lead you today. They're going to stand down here in front of you. My boys, I love you, Bash. I love you, son. Hey, you know that. Willie, I love you, buddy. I'm so proud. Gary, come here, buddy. I love you. All right, here's what we're going to do. Did everybody get back? Are you taking the box? I wanted all the elders to take communion today. You know, sometimes grown men are the hardest people to deal with. Oh, and all the wives said, I got three of them to listen to me. I don't know where the rest of them went. Real Roy, help me, buddy. Go herd them cats back in here. Tell them to shut that door and lock it. Come on. Ain't nobody going to touch that. God will kill them right in front of that door. Correll got out in front of the door. Nobody gonna make. Hey, Real Roy, you just prop that door open and pray with your eyes open for a few minutes, will you? Tell them gentlemen to come on. Come on, fellas. I ain't mad at you. I just want you to take communion with us. Real Roy's gonna pray right there at the door with his eye open, watching that door until y'all get back in there. I want you to take communion. You all need it. Come on, we sang a verse in that song a while ago, drink from the cup in his hand. He was wounded for our transgressions, bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And by his stripes, Y'all know that? I didn't think I could do it. By his stripes, stage four, anything is healed. Stage three, stage two, stage one. It ain't over till it's over. It's healed in his name. By his stripes, we are healed. So that night he took bread and blessed it. I bless it in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. He broke it, gave it to his disciples, and said, take this and eat. This is my body. By your stripes. Listen, there's not a, what you think you ate just a little wafer just then, there's not been a pill made. There's not been a medication that's been made that had more power than what you just swallowed. When you did that by faith just then, when you swallowed that, you believed that that was his body, and by his stripes you are healed. Then that cup, oh my God, I'm shaking already. I'm shaking already. He took a cup and he blessed it. I bless it in the name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. He gave it to his disciples. He said, he said, take this and drink. This is my blood. As it goes by that black heart of mine, as it goes by that darkness in me and washes me white as snow. Oh my God. Didn't that taste like cold water on a hot day? Washed my sins away. How many of them did it wash away? How many? All. Past, present, and future. How many sins did he wash away? All my sins.
I will rejoice.
And I'll be glad.
And be glad.
Would you do something that I fail to do sometimes? You've got some incredible elders in this church that love you and love this church. Would you give them a hand clap appreciation as they go to work? We're going to go ahead and let our children go to children's church so Miss Harley can go to work. Would you give our children a big hand clap appreciation for being with us today from children's church?
I will rejoice.
You, Bob.
Thank you for the river. I will
rejoice. Whoa. I will rejoice.
And be glad. And I'm gonna be glad.
And be glad.
Whoa. One more time. Sing it out. Say,
I will rejoice.
Give him a hand clap of praise today for what he's done. We're going to continue to pray. You can be seated. We can pray sitting down, I think, can't we? We've got some very important prayer requests, and I've got some bittersweet news this morning that Grant and Connie Ross are heading back west, and we want to pray for them that God will give them traveling mercies, and they're going to stay closer to our church the next time they're in town. And she just said it's hard to find a home away from home. They're from Texas, and they're snowbirding, but we're so glad to have them and had them with us for this time. So we love you. Thank you. And we're going to find you a good church in that other place you're going to stop by. I won't tell nobody where you're at. Y'all may be undercover agents or something. I may be letting stuff out. And yeah. But we're going to pray that God lets you find another church. And I'm praying he lets you find one better than ours. You're not going to, but I'm praying that. All right? Joanne, God's got this. God's got this. Just like you said. It's not what a doctor says. It's not what a doctor says. Tony Zachary lost his gallbladder this week. He's moving up. But he's better. Sharon Rudder. God bless her and heal her today. And Clara Morris, they got some bad news this morning that what's good news and bad news, that they found some things they didn't know was wrong with her, but she is in critical condition. She has got pneumonia, she's got COPD, she's got a broken, fractured back that the hospital missed and sent her home, and she went in excruciating pain, had to come back to the hospital, and they've got her sedated now because she's also claustrophobic and she can't stand that BiPAP machine that they've got her on. So she is Jennifer Zachary's mother. She is tough as a pine knot, but she needs God to touch her today. Bob Parrish is a sick little boy today. He needs God to move and to touch him today. He's very nauseated. He's very sick. They're doing tests tomorrow to see if it's something worse than what they think it is, but Reba said he desperately needs prayer today. Jerry McQuarrie, God's already touched you again, buddy. I watched him a while ago. You're going to be fine. Your wife's going to be fine. Everything's going to be okay. It's going to be okay. Yes, sir. It's all right. You in order. Yes, sir. I had Logos Lodge, but I think God fixed that today too, didn't he? All right. Our Spanish church, our brothers and sisters on the other side of the wall, that God would bless them today. I hope they're still having church when we leave today. Christ the King that was with us for years, God would bless them. Beit Hillel, the Messianic Jewish congregation that meets here on Saturday, that God would bless them. They are part of our family. And that God would bless you and your family today. Can you sing that prayer one more time? That is favor. Listen, this is the prayer we're going to pray today. Can we pray it together? Come on, just put the words of that song up. Let's sing it. Let's sing a prayer. That's what David did. Those psalms were prayers that he would sing. Come on, let's sing it, Justin.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace and give you peace.
All right, y'all know it. Let's sing it.
Come on, sing that again. Say, the Lord bless.
The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious.
The Lord turn his face.
The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Say amen.
Father, and all these folks that we've mentioned today and those that we failed to mention today, bless them and keep them. Let your face shine upon them. Be gracious to them. Lord, turn your face toward them and give them peace.
And give
amen.
You peace.
Do you agree today with me to say amen? We bless your name one more time. God, I take the right as the priest of this house to invoke a priestly blessing upon this congregation. That God, you flow through me today. Use me today, God, and bless these people today. Bless them and use them and help them. Encourage them, strengthen them. And let the words of that song, let the meditation of their heart be acceptable to you. Oh Lord, our strength and our Redeemer, until you come, we worship you. Amen. Amen. We bless you today. Now let's give him one more big praise today, can we? Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on, how do you thank somebody that's done it all? He's done it all. Hallelujah. And he'll do it again. He'll do it again.
Yes, he will.
Listen. If I don't get this word out of me, it's going to kill me. I've shook all week. I've had to lay down. I've been so weak. I've been so exhausted. I've never felt this way in my entire ministry. Are you ready? Let's just get in the word. Ernie, how many angels?
Just one.
One angel. Ernie remembered that. We walked into men's meeting fellowship yesterday. Ernie looked at me and said, Pastor, one angel. Well, I've got something I don't want you to forget today. Are you watching? That's going to be your next question that you ask people. Are you watching? Are you watching? Not Fox News, not CNN. Are you watching? Are you watching? Don't forget our Good Friday service and Easter service coming up, and you better fill this place up twice, first service and second service. And you better call all your friends, and I think you will after today. I think you'll let them know today. Turn with me to Matthew chapter 24 and verse 36. But of that day and hour no one knows, not even the angels of heaven, but my Father only. But as the days of Noah were, so also will be the coming of the Son of Man be. For as in the days of the flood they were eating and drinking and marrying and giving in marriage until the day that Noah entered the ark, and did not know. They did not know, listen to me, until the flood came and took them all away. So also will be the coming of the Son of Man be. Then two men will be in the field. One will be taken and the other one will be left. Two women will be grinding at the mill. One will be taken and the other one left. Watch, therefore, for you do not know what hour your Lord is coming. Did you just hear me? Watch, therefore, for you do not know what hour your Lord is coming. Do you know what the word therefore means? For that reason, that you don't know when the Lord is coming, that's why you need to watch. Are you watching? Are you watching today? Matthew 24 and 15. Let's back up a little bit. Therefore, when you see the abomination of the desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet standing in the holy place, He said, whoever reads this, let him understand. Daniel chapter 9 and verse 3. Then I set my face toward the Lord to make a request by prayer and supplication with fasting, sackcloth, and ashes. And I prayed to the Lord my God and made confession and said, O Lord, great and awesome God, who keeps his covenant and mercy with those who love him and with those who keep his commandments. We have sinned and committed iniquity. We have done wickedly and rebelled, even by departing from your precepts and your judgments. Are you with me today? This is Daniel's prayer. Now look at what Daniel says in chapter 10, verse 13. It says, but the prince of the kingdom of Persia withstood me 21 days, and behold, Michael, one of the chief princes, came to help me, for I had been left alone there with the king of Persia. What I've just read to you is an incident where Gabriel had come and was speaking to Daniel when Daniel said, I want to know what's going to happen in the end. And Gabriel had spoken with him in a vision. So when he prayed this prayer, God dispatched Gabriel to bring the answer to what's going to happen in the end to Daniel. And on Gabriel's way, this was so, I can't even wrap a word around this. There's no nomenclature. This was going to be such a crippling moment for the enemy that the prince of Persia, a regional demonic force, rose up against Gabriel and fought him for 21 days. You remember a while ago, Brother Ernie said one angel was in a fight with these words. With what he spoke to Daniel for 21 days. And then God sent the archangel, Michael, and whooped his butt. I got a feeling that Michael's coming to get the devil. I just want to remind the devil today that Michael's probably the one coming to get him. I've seen Michael in a vision, in a dream or something. I don't know what it was, but I was going through hell and I can tell you what he'll look like, and if I'm wrong, you just tell me I'm wrong when you get there. But he's the prettiest man I've ever seen. He's black. He's about 6'4". He's got a 12-pack. He's got piercing blue eyes. He's as bald as Clint Folsom. He's got arms bigger than my thighs. Good. Somebody said, good God Almighty. He makes Mr. Clean look like a wimp. He showed up in my life. And he would grab them little demons. And when he would grab one of them, they would just dissipate or just shatter into, like you've seen these vampire movies where they stab them and they just go into a puff of oblivion. That's what those little demons that were all around me, and he just throw them away. Then he kept doing it. He was standing there. He was sweating like a Hershey bar. That sweat running down. Prettiest man that I've ever. I've lied. I used to say I'd never seen a pretty man until I seen him. I was mesmerized by him. Never seen anything that like him. And he walks up and he sticks his hand out and he said, hey, Pastor, I'm Mike. That's what he did. Put his hand out and said, hey, Pastor, I'm Mike. If you need me, you just tell him and I'll be here. And these big, I didn't tell you how he came. I saw a ball of fire fall from heaven. And it hit the ground and the dust. When the dust cleared, I seen him stand up. And two big white wings went into his back, and they disappeared. And as soon as he shook my hand and said, if you need me, just let him know, those wings came back out, and a bolt of lightning left me where I was standing. I was at Ted Haggard's church down in Colorado Springs, Colorado. And I was walking over to the World Prayer Center that, you know, Ted Haggard may have messed up, but the man had a vision from God. And he built that World Prayer Center, and it looks out, and some of you folks that have been able to go there and see it, it's amazing. And it's got a ticker tape that goes around the wall 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Prayers coming in every language that you can imagine, every tongue and nation sending prayers to that room. And intercessors lay there on the floor day and night, night and day, praying for those prayers that are coming through. I walked down the hallway, and I was going down through there, and I looked over to the right of him, and there was this painting, and there laid this man with a big white wing behind him on the ground and had his hand on his face, and it was Mike. And at the bottom of the picture, it said, Michael the Warring Angel. I tried to buy it. They said $1 million wouldn't buy it. That the man that painted it, this is the only copy, and he said God told him not to do another. I didn't have cell phones then. I had a black, what did you used to call them, blackberries or whatever. I wanted a picture of it. I'll go back there someday and take a picture and show it to you. But I seen him. Now he's come to help Gabriel. Are you with me? He's come to help Gabriel. He's come and whipped the prince of Persia behind. We don't know what he looks like or what he was, but this took Michael to come down, and it was over. Daniel chapter 12 and verse 10, many shall be purified, made white, and refined by, but the wicked shall do wickedly, and none of the wicked shall understand what I'm getting ready to say. But the wise, he said, somebody say the wise. The wise shall understand. Verse 11, and from the time that the daily sacrifice is taken away and the abomination of desolation is set up, there shall be 1,290 days. Blessed is he who waits and comes to the 1,335 days. So let's look at this just a minute. He said, but then you go your way until the end, for you shall rest and will arise to your inheritance at the end of days. This is Daniel, God speaking to us that Daniel is going to be a part of our future. That we're reading in the Bible today something that happened way back in the past, but this is still going to be part of our future. That we'll see Daniel someday when the Lord comes. In 600 BCE, they destroyed the temple in Jerusalem and sacrifice stopped. With the destruction of the temple, 1,290 years later, using the number zero, this is where we missed it, this is where I missed it, using the number zero brings you to 691 AD. What happened in 691 AD? Anybody know? You know, we were, Dan Motes and I were in Israel, and we were taking pictures of the Temple Mount, and Michael Utterback was just, he was disgusted. And I said, Michael, I said, what is it? He said, that wretched thing sitting up there on that hill, that Dome of the Rock. In 691 AD, the Dome of the Rock was built, and this was the words of Michael Utterback. He said, that abomination, that desolation of God's temple. Matthew 24, therefore, when you see the abomination of the desolation spoken by who? Daniel the prophet, standing in the holy place, whoever reads this, he said, let him understand. So in Daniel chapter 12, blessed is he who waits and comes to the 1,335 days. So if you take that 691 AD plus a day is 1,000 years, 1,000 years a day, put these days as 1,335. Do you know where that puts it? The year 2026. Did I read that right? So if you add this up, and that's the abomination, the desolation of the temple, which that's what all the Jews say that it is. It's got to go. You get up there, Dan and I. When you get close to it, if you're speaking Arabic, you're all right. If you're Allah Akbar, and you're all right. But if you say anything about Jesus while you're standing up there, or if you speak in tongues, God help a Pentecostal, they will arrest you on that Temple Mount and tell you to leave. Those Arabs will. That abomination, the desolation that stands where the temple of God used to stand. Anybody with me today? So this comes to the year 2026. Am I telling you that I know for a fact that Jesus is coming in 2026? No. 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 I just read you a scripture that says, let me look at it again. But of the day and the hour, no one knows. Not even the angels in heaven. But what I'm telling you is that you've got to watch. You got to watch. And Matthew 24 says, watch therefore. And therefore, meaning for that reason, watch therefore. For you do not know what hour the Lord is coming. But know this, he said, that if the master of the house had known what hour the thief would come, he would have watched and not allowed his house to be broken into. Therefore, you also be ready. This is Jesus talking to me. There you also be ready, for the Son of Man is coming in an hour that you do not expect. Are you watching? Are you watching? I can tell you somebody that is watching. When we were in Jerusalem, and we went over to the Eastern Gate and Slim Dan Moats, we went through an Arab symbol. We went through the Arab quarters. And I don't know what this means, but I got a feeling we was getting the whole flock. And whatever it meant, Michael was giving it right back to him, wasn't he, Dan? And they were slapping our car and everything. Scott, I'm scared to death. I'm a little fat white preacher in a car about this big, scared absolutely to death. These Arabs got knives that long hanging off their side, slapping our car, didn't want us around there. Vroom, and Michael Utterback doing 90 miles an hour through there. Going around curves, they chickens flying, everything. I mean, I'm telling the truth. Dan. Then we get up to this Arab cemetery. I said, what are we going to a cemetery for? He said, I'm going to take you somewhere. We pull into the Arab cemetery. We climb over Arabs' graves, monuments. We're climbing over tombs and everything. We get up there, and he said, this is the Eastern Gate. I said, what? That's the Golden Gate? This is the Eastern Gate. There was an old, broken-down Sears fence in front of it. And Dan was slim enough to squeeze in the fence. I couldn't. And after Dan got up to the Eastern Gate, I'm not sure that if I wanted to be skinny or not, because I heard stuff start rattling on top of the wall. Machine guns, cannons. Michael said there's a whole platoon up there of Arab soldiers. I said, what are they doing? He said, they're watching for Jesus to put his foot on the Mount of Olives and to walk over here through this gate. I said, what? He said, yeah, they're armed 24/7 right there. They think that bullets are going to stop him when he puts his foot on the Mount of Olives and he walks through the Eastern Gate. Can I tell you that you sitting here today in Ocala, Florida, might not be watching, but there's some old Arab brothers over on the wall that are Muslim and dumb as rocks, but they're smart enough to believe what this book says. They're smart enough to believe and to understand that one day Jesus is coming back. They don't even serve our God. We serve the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, who is the father of Jesus Christ, the holy, righteous Son of the living God. They serve Allah, who has no son, who's served by the children of Ishmael and a lot of other good Jewish people that came down through those lineages with the blessings of Abraham and the covenant of God. And that's why they are so blessed. But they are smart enough to know that they've got to watch, because at an hour when they think not, Jesus is going to put his foot on the Mount of Olives and walk through the eastern gate. And they're going to bulldoze him with machine guns. God, I started thinking about that, and I said, man, I felt like Clint Eastwood then. I was pulling my pants up and strutting like a little peacock, and I'm thinking, I'd like to be standing here when you open fire on him. Good God Almighty, I'd like to be standing here and watch him just go. I mean, the words out of his mouth, the scripture said. Speak the words that spoke us into existence. Well, speak them out. Ain't nobody going to stop him from walking through the eastern gate. But what I'm here to ask you today, are you watching? Are you watching? Do you not see that everything is starting to line up, and that wars and rumors and wars and earthquakes in diverse places and tsunamis and tornadoes and hurricanes and all this stuff, and this is just the beginning of sorrows? Are you watching? Because at any time, it doesn't say there has to be a certain time. And I can argue with the greatest theologians in this room that if God told me that nobody knows the hour, they can't tell me when he's coming. They can't tell me when he think he's coming. I can show you in scripture where it showed that he's coming in 2026, but I don't know that. But I can tell you one thing. Just as sure as God makes little green apples, he's coming. He's coming. He's coming. He's coming. Oh, I'm on. Justin, come up here. I'm landing, buddy. Now, in Acts chapter 1, verse 9, when he had spoken these things, Jesus telling them what to do, to go and tarry for the Holy Ghost, while they watched, he was taken up into the cloud and received him out of their sight. And while they were looking steadfastly toward heaven, as he went up, behold, two men in white who also said, men of Galilee, why do you stand here gazing up into the heavens? The same Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will so come in like manner as you saw him go into heaven. Somebody got it. I don't know who it was. Oh, you men of Galilee, why stand you here gazing? For the one, it's kind of like this. My mother-in-law would say it. High upon a mountain, from where he ascended, the angel of the Lord declared that it would be. He said, don't stand here gazing. Somebody help me today. Cause the one that you see leaving in like manner's coming back for you and me. And then the good ones would say, I believe he's coming back like he said. Come on, let's do it today if we don't do nothing else. I believe that a trumpet's gonna sound so loud. Someday he'll raise the dead in the twinkling of an eye. He's gonna split the eastern sky, and I believe it's coming back like he said. It's my favorite verse. I believe at his appearing, we're nearing. Oh, this could be the hour, and this could be the day when the saints from every nation might just lose their gravitation, and in the middle of the air be called away. But I believe he's coming back. Like he said, I believe. someday he'll raise the dead. Come on, that means mom and dad and all them other folks are going to be with us. I believe he's coming back just like he said. I believe the time is nearing when we'll soon see his appearing. Oh, and this could be the hour, and this could be the day when the saints from every nation, why, we'll just lose our gravitation, and in the middle of the air be called away. But until then, I believe he's coming back like he said. I believe that the trumpet's gonna sound so loud. Someday he'll raise the dead. In the twinkling of an eye, he's gonna split the eastern sky. And I believe he's coming back just like he said. You believe it today? Come on, sing it. I believe he's coming back like he said. I believe sounds so loud. Someday he'll raise the dead. In the twinkling of an eye, he's gonna split the eastern sky. And I believe he's coming back like he said. Now, if you believe that, you'd be acting a little different than what you are right now. I'm a little disappointed in you. I really am. Because unless you've got sin in your life and your heart's not connected with God the way it's supposed to be, you ought to be about the most excited person in Marion County today. And when you go to Popeyes or Kentucky Fried or Golden Corral or wherever you go and feast at McDonald's, would you do me a favor and just stand at the door a minute and look up? And Brother Ernie, when they say, "What are you doing?" We just gonna tell them, "We just watching." We just watching. Watching for what? Well, I'm glad you ask. If you got just a minute, because I believe he's coming back just like he said.